Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Austin from Curls in the Rack. Today we're going to be talking about the box squat. So first thing we're going to do set up for this movement is just set up just like we're going into a regular back squat, right? So I'm just going to find my good grip, get under the bar. I make sure that I'm braced and everything, so I'm squeezing my core, squeezing my glutes, and then make sure that I'm externally rotating my feet to the outside here. So I'm imagining my feet are on dinner plates, twisting the outside, and that'll drive my knees going outwards. So everything stays the same with our regular squat. We're just going to change up the depth a little bit. I step back to my box. I usually like to put my heels right up flat against the back of the box here. Again, I'll go through that same bracing strategy. Externally rotate, squeeze the glutes, squeeze the abs, make sure everything's tight, and then I'll go ahead and send those hips back for the squat. Down and back. I rock my weight fully back into the box, sit, pause, and then stand up from there. Big explosive push on that stand up. Down, pause, up. Now, you guys can work on the personal sticking point using this movement, and that's typically how I like to incorporate a box squat into my programs. And what I mean by sticking point is find that point in your squat where when you sit back into it, it feels like you're getting stuck right here, or that's the moment that you have to push the hardest. That's usually the depth that I'll try and put my box at. So if I know that my personal sticking point is right about this height, I'll aim to get my box right about there, set up from there, and then just work on that point as I'm working on those box squats. All right, so that's the barbell box squat.